Hi and welcome back for the part number 10 of the construction of a side-scrolling shooter in pixel art. This is the last video of this series and we'll see how to improve the code and fix the little things that we have left behind. This part is critical. You will always have to check your code to see if you have forgotten something or if something can be optimized. Let's see straight away the first thing to do. Let's go to our events. And in the enemy groups, we have to add another collision with the bullets. We have here the collision with the laser and the missile, but it is missing the fire bullet one. You might want to leave it to destroy enemies that are on the ground, but since we have none yet, let's enable it to kill the only enemy that is at the moment in the game. So just replace everything with the fire bullet. So from missile, we go on replace object and we select fire bullet, destroy and destroy enemy, and that's it. The next step to do is to destroy the player when there is a collision with the alien ship. Here in the bullet group, we have already the collision between the player and the enemy bullet. Let's copy it inside the enemy group and make sure to keep it inside the group, so it's easy to collapse the group and keep it all the code clean. Then we go back here and let's replace the enemy bullet with the enemy. Enemy bullet, enemy. And here, instead of getting some damage, we destroy the player ship directly. So let's select all these instructions here and let's drag them above on the main block. And let's get rid of the sub-events. So we are done. So here we disable the movement of the player and we enable the bullet movement for the fall. Wait 1 second, all the explosion effect, and so on until the game restarts as usual. So we are done with this one. Another thing to do is to add the sound effects for the other bullets. We have done it one only for the laser until now. And it's here. So when it's created, create the sound effect. So we duplicate this and we go to replace the kind of bullet. This one we replace it with missile. And this one we replace it with the fire bullet. Now we go back to the sound folder and we load all the file, import sounds. And the first one we use explosion 03, I think, if I'm correct, for the fire bullet. And then for the missile, import sound. I have done sound rocket. Okay, import. Okay, now we just replace here as usual. We put rocket 1 and change the tag. Tag is always useful in case you want to stop the sound during the game for everything. So get used to give a name to this. And let's do this fire or fire bullet maybe. Okay. And that's it, this part is finished. Since we are doing the sound effect, let's keep working with them. On the start of layout, we are going to play a sound effect that gives us an idea that the game is starting. So we import sound, and we go to choose charging, 01, import, okay, add action, audio, play, and we choose here charging, and as usual we put the tag charging, done. Then we go on the system, we wait for 1 second or maybe 2, and now let's add something new, that's the music. It is very similar to the sound. Just need to go on the music folder. Construct 2 could accept MP3 music, but due to the copyright reason for the use of the format, you will have to convert in an OGG format. If you search on the internet, you will find many websites that do the conversion online without you have to install anything on your computer. I have created just for the occasion this chiptune music. It is my first one, so it's not the best one you will find around, but I enjoy creating it, so I will suggest you to try and experiment. You can create yours as well. It's easy to do. You find, as usual, something, some online tool that you can create yours and then save it directly. So we have 8-bit shooter as a name. Maybe we just write music as a tag. Let's keep it simple. And make sure to put looping, so the music, every time that finish, it will start again. Keep looping all the time. Now, and that's it for now. I think with the music and sound effect that we are done for today, we can add more if you want by yourself. Now let's add a new group to keep things more in order, and let's call it a UI. That stands for user interface. You can create a group called HUD if you prefer, where you are going to add all specific elements related only to the HUD. In this case, the game is very small, so it doesn't really matter to have many subdivisions. Let's add some sub events here, and let's drag here the every tick event that updates the life bar. It is not part of the main game, so we want to keep it aside from the rest of the game for easy reading. Also easy to group things together, as we have always done. Now, one improvement we can add to the game is to make the life bar semi-transparent when an enemy spaceship or the players goes on top of it. At the moment when something goes in the life bar area, they are covered by it. This because the life bar is on the layer user interface that is above the rest of the game. So that is quite annoying because you cannot really see what's happening on the ground. You know, you can have some bullets or that you want to avoid, or some power up, and you are going to miss it. To fix this issue, we go to our new sub event and we act on the life bar container. We use it as a condition because it is larger than the life bar. So when it is overlapping another object, in this case the player, okay, then we make this block an all condition and we duplicate the condition. Let's drag it down, and once done we replace it, the player, with the enemy. So when the life bar container is above one of these two, the life bar container set opacity to 30. 100 is the maximum full color, while 0 is totally invisible. So we are giving 30% transparency. And let's duplicate this. Let's make it large so you can see better what is behind. And let's replace the object with the life bar. Okay. At this stage, we do right click on the condition and we add else. Add else. Let's copy the instructions. Okay. So we have that if the overlapping is not happening, we need to have the life bar and its container with an opacity of 100. Let's now go to have a quick look to our changing to see what's happening. And we go on the run layout. And let's see. Okay, the sound effect started. The music as well. There is a transparency when we go underneath. Let's see if some enemies go behind the life bar to see the transparency. Another thing to do is adding the sound effect or feedback anyway to the power up when you collect it. So let's go to have a look how can we do it. Let's go on the power up group, and when the player collides with the power up, let's add a sound effect. Maybe we can use the same that we have used at the beginning of the game. So let's see, now play, and we choose charging, not looping of course, and let's call it power up. Even if it is the same sound effect, we give it a different tag name because it is used in a different way, and we might want to stop only one of these and not both. So just keep a different name every time you have a different reason for use the same sound effect. Let's do another quick test of the game, run layout, and then I will leave you some homework to do. Let's wait until we get some enemies and then the power up. Okay, first power up. Let's hear the sound. It's making the sound as expected. Let's now see the things to fix. If you notice, sometimes the enemy go entirely outside the screen. They don't reappear anymore. They are destroyed because in the enemy behavior, we have said that once it is outside the layout, it has to be destroyed. This is the first thing to fix. I leave this to you to fix. I want you to experiment, and in case, leave me in the comments if you have been able to fix it or if you have some problems. If you are able to make some demos, you can upload them to the internet and link them and share with all the other people. By the way, in the future I'll make a video about how to export in HTML5 format and how to publish your game on a website. Many websites host your game for free and you can share it with millions of users around the world. So this is a good chance for you to use Construct 2 for have your official first game around. I really want to see what you can do by yourself. So after having completed this first video game tutorial with Construct 2, you are able for sure to solve these problems. There are many ways issue can be fixed, so everyone can come up with something interesting, and it's really up to your creativity. Let's move now to the second issue to fix. That is that when the enemies go outside the screen, either above, at the bottom, or on the left, and they are destroyed, the player gets the points for them. Therefore, the player gets always 10 points, even when the enemies go outside the screen and it shouldn't normally happen. You have to shoot to them. So fix even these things here and let me know what are you able to do to solve the problem. The last thing that comes in my mind to fix, when the bullets go outside the game area, let me change the background color to see better maybe. And let's go on layers, background, background color, and let's put yellow. Okay, so when the bullets go outside the window area, they keep going to the right until they reach the extreme right side of the end of the layout. Only at that stage, the destroy outside the layout behavior gets rid of them. Therefore, when we create the enemies and we create them approximately in this area, the bullets that you create destroy the enemies even before they are able to come inside the screen. This is a problem that is absolutely necessary to fix. It might be easy to fix, it might be hard, it all depends on the way you are approaching the problem. As usual, it's up to you, experiment and let me know. I'm really curious to see all the different solutions that you will come up with. I remind you that if you're happy with this video series and you want to support me in creating more, you can buy all the assets present in this tutorial. You will find many spaceships, all the bullets, buildings, the life bar, the power up, and even the sound effect and the music. In the description, you can find the link to the websites where you can download the asset pack. You can use the asset to follow this course step by step, and you can also use them to publish your first commercial game. So if you like them, I think it's a good deal for you. As a last note, you will see at the end of the video, among the links, one that shows how using this video tutorial, some little bit of more effort from your side and the assets, you can have a fully playable game even using the free version of Construct 2. Of course, you cannot create a big game with many levels, different monsters, lots of power-ups and so on with the free version of Construct 2. However, you can create a small game with one or two levels or an endless game like the one I have done and you will see in the video. If you put effort, it is always possible to do something interesting, even with significant restrictions. It's all up to you to practice more and squeeze as much as you can from these 100 command lines. Another trick you can use to get as much as you can from this version is to add a comment. Click on any event and press Q. You will add a comment that is in addition to being useful for you to clarify what a piece of code is doing, is not counted among the 100 lines limit. You can, therefore, use it to replace groups if you have a desperate need of an extra couple lines. The main reason to use a comment is anyway to add details, information to part of the code. So, when you will go back to check some old code, it will refresh your mind. Especially when you will work with hundreds and hundreds of lines of code. Besides, if you think to sell your code one day, as full game or template, the person that will read it needs to understand well what you did. It is never easy and straight away to read someone else's code, so keep it clear. Think if you create a template like Pac-Man, and you want to sell it to show how the complex artificial intelligence works, so people can create a similar game. Without adding any comment, people will get mad at you because it isn't easy to understand what you have done. To conclude, comments are not useful only for yourself to refresh your mind, especially maybe after your holiday trip, but also to anyone that might have a look at your code later on. Goodbye for now. I hope that you have enjoyed this first tutorial. Let me know if you have a specific request for the next videos, since I am evaluating many options for the creation of the future courses. I will try to follow the more popular requests, still trying to use for the moment the free version of Construct 2. Even with its limitation, with efforts and creativity, we can still get some nice game out of it. Until you will be ready to move to the full version, of course. Thank you again for having followed this course. Remember to subscribe the channel if you want to know more about the new video tutorials, but also about the games that I'm developing too. Don't forget to check out the link at the end of the video to see what game you could realize following this tutorial and using my assets. Thank you once more. See you soon. Bye.